Hey everybody, and welcome back to Penn's Pulse. I'm Colby Armstrong, also known as the player to score the fastest goal in Winter Clasic history, and the first. Sometimes I brag about that.
Here are the Penguins driving to the Buffalo net, and Crosby knocked away and picked up right in front by the Penguins, and Colby Armstrong has scored immediately for the Pens. 21 seconds in. Oh, great balls of fire.
Since 2008, the NHL has began a tradition of playing at stadiums like this in football or baseball all over the country. And the Penguins, they're no stranger to braving these conditions.
Moving right in, it's Malkin on a breakaway.
The 2023 NHL Winter Clasic at Fenway Park marks the team's sixth appearance in an outdoor game. The game between the Penguins and the Bruins is a rivalry that's almost as old as the ballpark itself.
Snowy day, celebration of hockey in Buffalo. 73,000 here, and Sidney Crosby's line starts against that of Tim Connolly.
The first one always stands out the most because we didn't really know a lot about it. We didn't know what to expect. You couldn't even really imagine it. And then to walk out in Buffalo and have the snow coming down, be playing an NHL game outside, it was pretty unique, pretty special.
The game on his stick right here. Score! Penguins win!
A picture-perfect ending to the inaugural Winter Clasic set the stage for a new NHL tradition, a marquee event that kicks off the new year.
Tonight will be a game for remembering, and the Penguins will take on the Philadelphia Flyers outdoor here at Heinz Field before 65,000 plus. And it will be an exciting game, to say the least.
That wind is howling. It is whipping through this open end, and at times it's swirling.
Woo! Here we go, boys. Let's be ready to play here.
Here's Gensel, side of the net, score! It's Crosby, and it's 1-0.
Playing it in those outdoor games, it's just, you don't get too many opportunities. It's an exciting time to kind of do something new. You play however many games over the course of a season, over your career. This experience of being able to go play outside and have the unexpectedness of what kind of weather are you going to get, how's the ice going to be, and playing in front of those huge crowds, I think just makes it that much more fun.
Try to give and go here, and it comes in, scores! On the follow, the puck came back to Rust, and he ties this game at 3 goals apiece.
Fenway Park's gonna be really cool. I was fortunate enough to play one there when I was in college. Played under the lights, it was a night game. Definitely one of the experiences that I'm never gonna forget.
You know, it's something that definitely the guys look forward to. You know, you kind of got it circled on your calendar. It's, you know, it's a pretty big event for the NHL, and I've played there once before, and it's the scene in Boston at Fenway is, you know, I'm not sure that you can really top that in terms of, you know, history and stadiums and whatnot.
It just takes you back. That's where, as a kid, you know, you played on outdoor rinks, and that's where you dreamed of playing the NHL. And to do it now as an NHL player at a place like Fenway, I mean, I went to a baseball game as a kid at Fenway, and I never would have thought I'd be playing a hockey game there.
We always look forward to these events. They're unique experiences. It brings you back to your childhood days when you're playing outside on a pond. And I think the league does a great job organizing it and in being so inclusive with family.
First time, like, my son, like, will be skate with me. Like, he's never skate outside 70,000 building. It will be a good memory for my family, for sure.
Today, from Fenway Park in Boston, Massachusetts, it is truly a great day for hockey as the Penguins and the Boston Bruins take it outside for the 2023 Discover NHL Winter Clasic. Penguins are going to have a different look here today. The cream color logo with the old nod to the Pittsburgh Pirates hockey team.
The jersey that we unveiled for the Winter Clasic harkens back to the origins of hockey in Pittsburgh. It was the 1920s when the original Pittsburgh Pirates was the hockey team in Pittsburgh. And what a lot of people don't know is that the black and gold that we wear today is because of that team. In the 1970s, folks will remember the Penguins were actually blue. And when the Steelers and Pirates were winning championships, we decided as a city to change our colors to black and gold. And originally the Bruins weren't in favor of that. They actually fought us on it. And it was because of that jersey, because of that team in 1920, it's why we wear the black and gold. So today is about celebrating that history of hockey in Pittsburgh and to honor their sweater here in 2023.
Here we go, baby. What a better way to kick it off. Pens and Bruins, man, at Fenway Park.
All right, Winter Clasic. Every year I watch the first 21 seconds. I only watch the first 21 seconds. And that's it. And I still send a tweet out after. Still got it.
It'll be Sidney Crosby and Patrice Bergeron, the captains, on the opening faceoff. Sticks are down, puck is down, and we are underway.
There we go. It's gonna have to be a miracle. I mean, oh. Flipped out to center. No. Still got it.
Here's a chance in front. Kasperi Kapanen shoots and scores. Oh, how sweet it is. It's 1-0 Pittsburgh here at Fenway.
Despite falling short as the game came down to the final seconds, the Penguins walked away with a memorable experience at America's most beloved ballpark.
Some players go without playing any of these, and I've been lucky to get two, and an amazing atmosphere out there.
One of the most famous stadiums in the world. Makes for a great experience for the players, great experience for the fans. Really fortunate to be a part of it.